Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. 'Cause he's my rock. He's my fortress. He's my deliverer. Will I trust? So praise the name of Jesus. Come on, lift your voice. Say praise the name of Jesus. Come on, lift your hands and say praise the name of Jesus. He's my rock. Come on, y'all. And he's my deliverer. He's my deliverer. And him will I trust. Come on, y'all. So praise the up your mouth in here and give him the praise that's due. Come on, we give you glory. We give you honor in here, oh God. Come on, come on. We give you glory in here, oh God. Come on, for the next 30 seconds, come on, lift up your voices in here. Begin to exalt him. Come on, speak highly to him. Come on, you're righteous. You're omnipotent. You're everything we need in this moment. Come on, come on. Through it all, we give you glory in here, oh God. We give you glory and honor. We give you glory. We give you honor, oh God. Come on, put your hands together, y'all. Come on, clap, clap. Come on, put those hands on. Come on, the altar is open. Come on, y'all. I don't know what you come to do, everybody said. Come on, put those hands on it. What you come to do, everybody say nah, nah. Come on, turn to your neighbor and tell him. Say, but I know what I come to do, everybody say. Turn to somebody and say, but I know what I come to do. Top.
me. Watch me. Look at me. Praise the name of Jesus. Watch me. Watch me. Come on, everybody, clap. Hands on it. Come on. Everybody put those hands on it. If you don't want to dance, watch me dance. See, if you don't want to dance, watch me dance. If you don't want to praise him, watch me praise him. If you don't want to praise, watch me praise him. Now come on, give him a praise right there. Come on, give him a praise right there. Come on, turn to your neighbor and say, don't let the rock cry out for you. Come on, Nick. We praise the name of Jesus in here. Lift your hands all over the room. Oh my God, oh my God, yeah. I can't deny what you've done for me. You loosed all my shackles and set me free. You rolled me and gave me the victory. I got a reason to praise. I can't deny what my eyes have seen. What seemed impossible, I believe. Rolled me and gave me the victory. I got a reason to praise. Said I won't let a rock cry out for me. I won't let a rock cry out for me. Come on, let me hear your praise in there. Come on, open up your mouth all over the room. Come on, help us out. Said, I can't deny, say,
I can't deny what you've done for me. Loosed all my shackles and set me free.
She rolled me and gave me.
Rolled me and gave me the victory. I got a reason to praise.
Come on, say,
I can't forget what my eyes have seen. What seemed impossible,
I believe.
Look at my life, we got history. I got a reason to praise.
Come on, say, here y'all.
Cry out.
Said,
I won't
cry out for me.
I won't
let it rock.
Cry out
for me.
Let it rock.
Come on, lift your hands all over the room and open up your mouth and hear y'all. Come on, somebody open up your mouth all over the room. We give you glory in here. Give you glory and honor. We give you glory. Said, I will not be silent. I'm gonna keep on singing. We will not keep quiet. We're gonna keep on praising. I will not be silent. I'm gonna keep on singing. Just wave your hands in the atmosphere. Say,
I'm not afraid.
we will. Come on, somebody lift your hands all over the room and give them the praise through the situation. Even though you got victory, give them glory. Give them glory. Come on, lift your hands. If they don't praise you, I'll still praise you. Continue to praise Him through every situation. If they don't, I will praise Him. Oh my God, I won't let her out. Cry out, cry out, cry out. Come on, somebody, cry out, cry out, cry out. Come on, say, cry out, cry out. Say, cry out.
Cry out.
Come on, lift your voices. Here, come on.
Cry out. Cry out.
Come on, lift your voices.
Cry out. Cry out. Cry out.
We give you glory in this moment. Come on.
Cry out.
Give them all the glory.
Cry out. Cry out.
Somebody call on the name of Jesus.
Cry out. Cry out.
Somebody call on the name of Jesus.
Cry out.
So cry out.
Cry out.
Come on, lift your hands right here. And cry to the King. Come on. You're worthy of it all. Cry out.
Cry out.
Cry out.
Cry out.
Come on, lift your hands all over the room.
Cry out.
We'll give you glory in here. Come on, get lift your hands all over the room. Come on, this is a good place to praise Him. Now just think about everything you've been through. Now He keeps on providing for you. Now begin to speak highly to Him. We just say thank you to the righteous one. And I will not be silent. And I will always worship you. As long as I'm still breathing, I will always worship you. So somebody cry out, cry out, cry out. Somebody cry out. Somebody cry out, yeah, yeah, yeah. Somebody cry out in here. And I will not be silent. I will always worship you. As long as I'm breathing. 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 As long as I'm breathing, as long as I'm breathing. Come on, lift your hands right here. And I will not be silent. I will always worship you. Come on, same thing, same thing. As long as I'm still breathing, worship you. Here's my worship. All of my worship. Receive my worship. All all of my worship, and I will not be silent. I will always worship. Turn the pad down. As long as I am breathing, I will always. Come on, lift your voices. Come on. And I will not be. Come on, this is a good place to talk to him. As long as, oh my, my, my God. Come on, lift your hands right here. Open up your mouth. Come on, Brother Greg. Come on, turn up the guitar. Come on, just lift your hands in the atmosphere and begin to talk to him. We give you glory in here, oh God, oh God. As long. Come on, all over the room, lift up your hands. Come on, begin to worship him in here. Oh my God, I'll always worship you. Receive it now, oh God. Receive the worship now, oh God. I will always worship you. Come on, go to the floor. We give you all the glory to the one. Come on. Now take this moment to talk to him. Come on. Have your conversation with him. Tell him how grateful you are. We give you glory in here, oh God. Everything to me, everything to me. Come on, just pat it in. You're everything to me. You're everything to us. You're everything to me. Life and breath. everything to me. You're everything to me. Come on, lift your hands right here. So take everything. I don't want it. I don't need it. God, won't you take everything? I don't want it. And I don't need it. God, I just want you. I just want you. I just want you. I just want you. We just want you. I just want you. I just want you. I just want you. Come on, lift your hands. Take everything, Lord. Take everything. I don't want it. I don't need it, God. Take everything. I don't want it. And I don't need it, God. I just want you. I just want you. I just want you. I just want you. We just want you. I just want you. I just want you. I just, come on, y'all. Say, take everything, Lord, take everything. I don't want it. And I don't need it, God. Take everything. Just want you, just want you. I just want you. I just want you. Come on, turn up the guitar. Come on now, lift your hands all over the room and begin to release it to him. Come on, release it, release your worship. Come on, we give you glory in here, oh God. Just want you. We just want you. Yeah, 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 yeah. Come on, the altar is open. Come on, lay it here on the altar. We lay it here on the altar. We desire more of you. We desire more of you. We desire more of you. I just want. Just want you. Just want you. Just want you. to take. Come on, B. Come on, turn the guitar. To take everything. Come on, tell them what you want. I just want you. I just want you. I just want you. Come on now, take this moment right here. The altar is open. Come on, release. If you had a long week, just release it here. Come on, God. We give you glory in here, oh God, oh God. So take everything. I don't want it, and I don't need it. God, take everything. I don't want it. I don't need it. I don't want it. I don't need it. I don't want it. And I don't need it. Now lift your voices all over the room. Come on, lift your voices all over the room. There's a new horizon on the way. Come on, lift your hands. Hello. Yeah. We give you glory in here. Oh, God. Come on, just talk to him. Talk to him here. Over the ocean, over the sea, through every trial, there's a new season for me. There's a new horizon. There's a new horizon. Come on. There's a new horizon. I give you glory in here. Come on, lift your hands high. Your horizon is here. Come on. Your new horizon is here. Give you glory in here, oh God. So hello, peace. Hello, joy. Hello, love. Hello, strength. Hello, hope. It's a new horizon. Hello, peace. Hello, joy. Hello, love. Hello, strength. Hello, hope. It's a new horizon. If you're ready for a breakthrough, you can open up and just receive. Cause what he's pouring out is nothing you've ever seen. You've ever seen. So hello, peace. Hello, joy. Hello, hello, strength. Hello, hope. It's a new horizon. Come on, do it for yourself. Come on, wait. Hello, peace. Hello, joy. Hello, love. Hello, strength. Hello, hope. It's a new horizon. Come on, lift your voice.
It's a new horizon.
Come on, speak it over your life here. Come on. It's a new horizon.
It's a new horizon.
Everything you've been waiting for.
It's a new horizon.
It's a new horizon.
It's a new horizon.
And it's coming my way. And it's coming my way. And it's coming my way. Fear is not my future. You are. Sickness is not my story. You are. Oh my God. And heartbreak is not my home. You are. And death is not the end. Yeah. You are, and the sickness is not your story.
You are.
Heartbreak is not my home.
Heartbreak is not my home. You are. You are.
Death is not the end.
Death is not the end. You are.
Come on now, wave to it. Say hello. Joy.
Hello,
hello, strength.
Hello,
whatever you need is in the house today. Say hello.
Hello,
hello,
joy. Hello,
hello, strength.
Hello,
hope.
Hello, hope.
It's a new. Speak it over our lives today. We will not be in the same position. We will not be in the same place. He's going to elevate you more and more. If he did it for David, he can do it for you. Somebody wake up now, now, now. They thought it was impossible. But God woke you up this morning.
Wake up.
And showed you what's new for you.
Wake up.
So wake up. Come on, somebody wave to it. Come on, wave it prophetically. Come on. Hello, stream. Oh, God. It's a new horizon. A new horizon. Fear is not my future. Oh my, 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 yeah. And sickness is not your story. Come on, say it from your heart. Heartbreak is not my home. Come on, they thought you were going to die on it. Death is not the end. They thought your dreams were going to die. But we're going to say death is not.
Death is not the end.
We ask every dream to rise here.
Death is not the
end. We ask it to become reality.
Death is not
we speak
the
a new horizon
end.
Over it.
Death is
somebody
not
look
the
over
end.
The ocean now, now, now.
Death is not
it's getting
end.
Closer for you.
Death is not the
death
end.
Is not the end. Because he's alive, I'm alive. He's alive, I'm alive. Because he's alive, I'm alive. Said it's not over for you. Said it's not over. So hello. Somebody wave at you. Come on, somebody wave at your horizon. Come on, come on. We bless the name of Jesus. Said it's coming my way. Come on, we lift you up higher. We lift you up higher, God. up. We ask you to rise up in Jesus' name. What you thought is impossible, he can make it possible. Every miracle show up now, now. As we lay it here at the altar, renew our strength, renew our strength. Come on, speak it over your life here.
It's a new horizon.
It's a new horizon.
It's a new horizon.
It's a new horizon. Come on, sing it over your life. Come on, sing it over your life.
It's a new horizon.
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 It's a new horizon. Come on, lift your hands all over the room and speak it over your family here. Speak it over your job that you will get the promotion because you deserve it. Come on.
It is coming my way.
We're getting a little closer, closer, closer. A little closer, closer. Come on, lift your hands all over the room. It's a new horizon. Come on, just for a moment, lift everybody, lift your hands here and begin to receive it. Come on, grab it. Grab it. Receive it now. Receive it now, 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 now. It's a new horizon. Come on, God, open up our eyes so we can see it clear. It's a new horizon. Come on, a few more seconds. Come on. Here is not my future. Sickness is not my story. Heartbreak is not my own, and death is not the end. Bless the name of Jesus.
Thank you. We always have hope. With you, all things are new. We bless you. Father, we thank you that you're a God of freshness and newness and wholeness. Glory to God. Father, we thank you for your word that says your mercies are new every morning. You've always got a new batch of mercy ready for us to help us, to have compassion on us, to lead us, to guide us. And we just bless you. God, we thank you this morning so much for who you are. God, you promised us that if we would believe in your Son and come to you, that you would be our God and we would be your people. And Father, we don't take that lightly, that we are your people, that we are your sons and daughters. And God, that is a big deal. And we just thank you so much that we're no longer limited by our natural heritage, but now we are the heritage of the Lord. Joint heirs with Jesus, heirs of God, and we just thank you for it. Father, help us to come out of the low life to live in the high life. And that we would not focus on earthly things, but that we would begin to focus on heavenly things. Our heavenly position, our heavenly power, our heavenly anointing, our heavenly provision. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We bless you. We honor you. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Us. To rise up. Bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, we thank you for your presence here today. We thank you that you are in our midst. Father, in Jesus' name, I pray that your power and your anointing would be manifested in this place. Father, we thank you that you meet us here. And you're ready and willing to bless us. Hallelujah. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. Now, I'm like way loud up here. Sounds like I've got metal all around me. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Why don't you turn to one or two people, tell them, I'm so glad to see you today. Praise the Lord. Tell them, you're my family. Mm-hmm. Tell them, so stop being a stranger. Stop looking at me like you never saw me before. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Well, let's give the praise and worship team a hand. Musicians. Thanks, y'all. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. All right. We're going to get started. Lift up your Bible. Say, this is my Bible. I am what it says I am. And I can do what it says I can do. And I can have what it says I can have. Say today, this day, after hearing and receiving the ever-living, the everlasting Word of God, I will never be the same again. Never, 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 never. Never, ever, 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 ever will I be the same in Jesus' name. So keep your ears open. Amen? Praise the Lord. Well, today I want to share the Word of God with you. You know, I brought in my Hebrew calendar, okay? This is God's calendar, right? And I want to, today we are in a season of what's called Hanukkah. Now, the Bible tells us that we are not obligated to follow feasts and Sabbaths, and things like that. But I believe, you know, when the Lord lays it on my heart, I believe that God, well, the Word of God says that God is gracious and full of compassion. God is always waiting for the opportunity to bless us. So once in a while, I'll use these celebrations and these feasts Because I know that God is always looking for an opportunity for us to use our faith to believe him for something. Right? You know, we have to use our faith. That's how we're supposed to function. It's supposed to be natural for us to believe God, to believe in his provision, to believe in his position, to believe in his favor, to believe in his power, to believe in his care for us, right? We all need to improve, don't we? There's something in our lives that's not just right, but God wants it to be right. And so he wants us to be blessed. So this past Friday was the first day of Hanukkah. And we'll look at a scripture. First day of Hanukkah, so it's from December 8th to December 15th, right? And again, to me, it's like the feast, I call it a divine opportunity because based on what the feast means, okay? So let's go to John chapter 10. Let me make sure I said all I wanted to say. John chapter 10 and verse 22. There you go. I don't know where to read the scripture anymore because it's all big. Oh, okay. And it was at Jerusalem, the feast of the dedication, and it was winter. And Jesus walked in the temple in Solomon's porch. Now, it just so happens that this feast of dedication, let's go back to verse 22. The feast of dedication is only mentioned one time in the New Testament. That word dedication actually means Hanukkah. So Hanukkah was a celebration of a miracle of God. How many of you could use a miracle? There was one person I had in mind who I know needs a miracle, and they're not here today. But we're all going to agree for miracles for our family. Amen? So if you need a miracle, if you need a miracle, I'll give you the definition in a minute, then I want to pray for you. And we're all going to agree that our family, whoever needs a miracle, gets a miracle. Now, right now, I don't need a miracle, right? I'm good at the moment. But if I needed a miracle, I should be able to believe God for a miracle, right? Because God, there are times when we need God to intervene, and he will, based on our faith. So the Feast of Dedication, again, it's only mentioned in John 10:22, but Jesus showed up at the temple, and it's called Hanukkah. Hanukkah means dedication. And so let me give you a little history. You know, there was a point where the temple was ruined. It was taken over by some rogue heathens, and they just desecrated the temple. The temple of God just tore it up, and, you know, they were sacrificing pigs on the altar, you know, and doing all kinds of foul stuff. And so at some point, some rogue Jews, they said, no, we want our temple back. And so they cleaned up the temple, they got rid of the altar, they got rid of the idol, and they cleaned the temple up. And so when they went to light the candle, there was only enough oil for one day. Now, Hanukkah is 8 days. So they lit the menorah, which is that candle with 9 candles on it. And but they only had enough for one day. So, but they filled the menorah anyway, and they lit it. So I'm not sure whether they were believing God for a miracle, or they just said, I'm just going to use what I have. That's another sermon. Just giving God what you have. You can't give him more than what you have. And God knows what you have, and he knows what you don't have. Amen? And so we can use that in a lot of areas. So they lit the menorah, and it turns out that when it came back, the first day was over of the 8 days, that the menorah, the candles were still lit, which means that that was a miracle, right? You can't, They didn't go back and refill it. They didn't go to the corner store and buy some. It was special oil anyway. It was anointed oil. It was a special recipe that they had to use to burn in the temple. So they couldn't just run out to the store, 7-Eleven, Wawa, y'all know what I'm saying, and just get any old bottle of oil. It had to be a special recipe. So, but they, when they cleaned up the temple, they found just one day's worth of oil. So this holiday, or this feast, which is a happy time. Somebody say it was a happy time. How many of you know God is a happy God? God's a happy God. I'll never forget Kenneth Copeland. How many know Kenneth Copeland? Anybody here know Kenneth Copeland? The Lord told Kenneth Copeland, he said, if it wasn't for sin, I wouldn't have had a sad day in my life. That's what he told Kenneth Copeland. So I said that to say that God is a happy God. God is full of joy. God is full of hope. He's love. So God's not a drag, right? He's not mean. You know, we've learned so many things. I didn't grow up in church. I know WDAS, they played songs. I think I just mentioned this recently. WDAS on Sundays, my mom would play it once in a while, and, you know, climbing up the rough side of the mountain, and life was so hard, and it made me afraid of God. I didn't want God, because what do they say? I can do bad all by myself. But God's not a do bad all by yourself type of God. He's a good God. He's gracious and full of mercy and compassion. That word gracious, it means disposed to show favor. It's God's attitude. It's God's disposition. It's God's desire to show us favor. Tell the person next to you, God desires to show you favor. He's not looking to whip you or to punish you, right? He's a father. He's a loving father who already poured his wrath out on Jesus Christ. So there's no wrath left to be poured out on us. He poured it out on Jesus Christ, right? So we don't have to, like, feel guilty all the time, feel bad all the time, feel imperfect, to feel insufficient, to feel unworthy. You're going to embarrass somebody. We can hear y'all back there. So what was I saying? God is a good God. And so God uses all these feasts, even though we are not obligated to follow these feasts or these holidays. But again, it's an opportunity. God will do. That's why we need the word of God. God will do whatever we learn about him. That's why we say, this is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I can do what it says I can do, right? Because God wants to do things for us. Amen? So he's not mad at us. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. So the people, so one day's worth of oil supernaturally lasted for 8 days. Somebody say, that's a miracle. And guess what? That means if they didn't put the oil in there because they didn't have any, that means heaven put the oil in there. Just like heaven will provide for us. And that's why we have to be miracle-minded people so that God can meet our needs. But we don't see that, do we? We don't learn that in the body of Christ because nobody's looking for one if you need one. Now, today I want to anoint some people with oil. One of our members, he needs a pituitary gland. So if he was here, I would anoint him with oil, and we'd all believe together for a new pituitary gland for him. Somebody say, that's easy for God. He's... What is too hard for God? Come on, think about it. What's too hard for God? Think about it. I mean, he's done so many things. We didn't witness it, but if we believe that this is true and that's his, it's his word, we believe that he parted the Red Sea and made the water walls and just stood up until his people crossed that river. Right? Somebody say, that's a miracle. Water don't stand up. Right? And make a wall. He's the God who, what's the story with Gideon? First, the fleece was wet and the ground was dry. Then the fleece was dry and the ground was wet. So God did that for Gideon just to show Gideon, yeah, I'm talking to you, son. And I need you to do this for me and defeat the Midianites. So God's a miracle working God, right? We just need to see him in our midst. And miracles are easy for God. That's our problem. We think something that's too hard for us is too hard for God, right? But that's a problem. And so that oil was a miracle. It was oil that was from above. It came from heaven. That oil for those 8 days out of one day. Remember Jesus, he blessed, he fed thousands of people with two fish and five loaves. Right? So that's a miracle. I wish I was there to see that happen. All we know is they kept putting their hand in the basket, and every time they put their hand in the basket, another fish came out. Another loaf came out. You know, and I'm sure they were amazed, like, wow, look at this. Look at this. But that was a miracle, right? How many of you know God will do that for us? If we need it, if we believe for it, if we get desperate enough to believe God for a miracle, amen, then he'll do it. He'll do it. Tell somebody, say, it's time to see miracles. So traditionally, Hanukkah was a happy and joyous time. So what they did, they would light their menorahs and they would put them in front of a door or put them in front of a window to commemorate Hanukkah. And they were telling people that God performed a miracle in the past and that he will perform a miracle now. Right? So that's why they lit the candles to commemorate a miracle working God. Amen. So between this past Friday and this coming Friday, we can look at that as a season for miracles. Right? So if you're desperate for something today, if physically you need a miracle, then this is the time, right? Again, this is an open window, open opportunity, right? How many of you, when there's a time for something, everybody shows up, right? And everybody has expectations. So if this is a time of miracles, then we should expect a miracle if we need one, right? So this is where we are, amen? So this Hanukkah, it also means, let me read a miracle, what a miracle is. A temporary or permanent interruption or change in the natural order of things orchestrated by God in order to bring about his plan. A temporary or permanent interruption or change in the natural order of things orchestrated by God in order to bring about his plan. In other words, God did it, right? He raised Lazarus from the dead. We already talked about Gideon with the fleece. Jesus cured incurable diseases. He opened blind eyes. He fed 5,000 with just a few fish and loaves of bread. So God's a miracle working God, amen? And he wants to work in our lives. Praise the Lord. So what we're going to do, Hanukkah is also a holiday for dedication. So they dedicated the temple, right? They dedicated or rededicated the temple to God. 1 Corinthians 6 says that we are the temple of the Holy Ghost. So I think today would be a good day for us to rededicate our lives to God. Amen. Y'all hearing me? Because I know, I already talked about it, we don't have things perfect going on, right? And so, but if we want to be blessed by God, we have to live right. Amen? So today is up until Friday, just to start. We do it later as well. But this is a time of rededication. Amen. Anybody here? Need a miracle? Do you need a miracle? Like, you need God to intervene because nothing else is going to do it. Nothing else is going to help you. Nothing else is going to fix it. I'm not talking about God gave you an instruction, like if you're broke, and he told you to sow a seed, and you haven't sown a seed. You know, 1 Kings 17, I think, is the woman at Zarephath, right? When the prophet showed up, she said, I just have a little bit of oil, a little bit of meal, and I'm going to make some, a little bit of food for me and my son to die. And Elijah said, make me a cake first. So that's a principle in the Bible where we give, if we take care of God. Now, the man of God in the Old Testament, he was the voice of God. He was the representative of God, especially back then. So some people might say, wow, that was selfish for him to ask her to make him a cake first when she hardly has anything left. But the whole point is you take care of God. If you put God first, seek you first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. So she sowed in to the word of God and into the man of God. And then she had oil unlimited. And it lasted her for a year. And she was able to make money. And that was a big deal for a widow because a widow had nobody to take care of her. Amen? So sometimes when we're suffering financially, we have to understand that we have to sow a seed. We have to give God. How many of you remember the woman who threw in the two mites, which I think is equal to a half of a cent? But she threw in, amen? She knew what, this ain't going to do nothing for me. So I'm going to give it to God and let him do something with it. I like saying we didn't hear the end of the story, but Jesus made a big deal. He said, look at her. She gave more than all y'all who were rich. So we know the end of the story, that God provided for her. So we have to get to a point, if we want to see a miracle financially as well, we need to take what we have, the little bit that we have, sow a seed for a miracle. Amen? Sow it into the kingdom. And I'm sure she saw a miracle and that her life changed. So we're going to, who raised your hand for a miracle? You need a financial miracle, a physical miracle, any kind of miracle. You need divine intervention. Okay? Yeah? All right. So hopefully some of you, anybody need a physical miracle? Yep, yeah, like you got something that's can't be cured. Dara told you we can't help you, ma'am. We can't help you, sir. Well, God wants to save you, and he wants to heal you. So I'm going to anoint you with oil, and we're all going to agree. And we're all we're all going to see this miracle come to pass. Right? If we watch our mouth, so after I do what I'm going to do, then you gotta say that you have a miracle, right? So you don't go home and auntie call you up, your sister call you up, and then you just go repeating what you've been repeating. Yeah, the doctor told me I had this, this person said that. No, we start saying what God said. We start saying that on December, what's today? December 10th? Which one is it, y'all? Somebody said the 9th. On December 10th, I received a miracle, right? And when I get a doctor's report, the doctor's going to say, ma'am, we can't see anything. We don't know what you're talking about, right? Because that's the kind of God he is. Tell somebody, say, God wants to save me. He wants to heal me. He wants to rescue me. He wants me to have a better quality of life. He wants to manifest himself to us. Amen? How can we have a testimony unless God shows up? Right? When will we ever get a testimony if God doesn't show up? What are we going to say? You know, we need something to say. Right? Tell the person next to you, you need something to say that God did in your life. Right? Otherwise, we're doing stuff on our own. Matter of fact, when we can do something on our own, we know God's not in it. Because if you can do it on your own, you didn't need God. Because God likes to do impossible things. Right? He likes to do hard things. Praise the Lord. All right, so, but before we do that, I want us to make some confessions, okay? It's very important. It's very important for us to learn how to talk. And to learn how to confess the word. And to learn how to use our mouth and our voice for our benefit. Right? And when we use our voice and give God permission, then he can respond and he can react to what we confess. Right? So we have to give him permission. He's not going to force us. How many of you got forced to get saved? Nobody could force you. You had to receive it yourself, your own heart, with your own choice and decision, right? It's the same thing with everything that we receive from God. We have to do it willingly, and we have to do it in faith, right? I can encourage you as much as I can, but unless you receive faith to receive from God, then you're not going to receive. Amen? That's just the way it is, right? But God will do it. Somebody say, God will do it. All right, so we're going to do that, and then I'm going to pray for those of you who need a miracle, where you need a temporary or permanent interruption or change in the natural order of things, or the natural course of things, I like to say, orchestrated by God in order to bring about his plan. Amen? God wants us to prosper. He wants us to be healed, right? He wants us to be happy. Right? He wants us to be provided for. Right? So, all right. So, let's say some things, okay? Let me make sure I read all my scriptures. Anyway, we're going to start off with, so you can stand to your feet, okay? So, we're celebrating miracles. If you don't need a miracle, yay. If you do need a miracle, yay. Amen? Praise the Lord. All right. Repeat this after me. Say, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Say, Heavenly Father, I rededicate my whole life to you afresh. Say, I and my body is the temple of the Spirit of God. And we're talking about they restored the temple and they rededicated the temple to God. Amen. Say, I will not walk in darkness. I will walk in your light. Say, Lord, I repent of walking in darkness. I turn from darkness. I turn from any sin in my life and turn to the light. Say, I dedicate my ways. I dedicate my words to you and to your kingdom. Say, I declare light over my life and my family. Say, Lord, touch your ears. Say, Lord, I hear your voice. Touch your eyes. Say, Lord, open my eyes. Let me see. Say, Lord, open my spiritual eyes so I can see your purpose, your dreams, your plans, and your direction. Touch your heart. Say, Lord, open my heart. Cleanse it from all fear, from all doubt, from all pride, in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Say, God, I need a miracle for Christmas. Say, God, I need a miracle for my family. Say, God, I believe for your supernatural provision in the next days and beyond. Say, thank you, Lord Jesus. Say, Lord Jesus, I thank you that my light shall never run out. My oil shall never run dry. Say, Lord, I believe in your everlasting provision for my life from heaven. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Now, I want you to just take a minute, amen. Take a minute. Ephesians 5:18, let's look at that. And I want us to pray in the spirit. All right, but if you all can put up Ephesians 5 in the Passion Translation, praise the Lord. So we need to refill. We need a refilling of the Holy Ghost. And it says, and don't get drunk with wine, which is rebellion. Instead, be filled with the fullness of the Holy Spirit. Let's read that again. And don't get drunk with wine, which is what? You know, even on the road, they tell you, buzz driving is drunk driving. So don't tell me sipping is okay. Even the law tells you don't be drinking. So now people differ. Pastors differ from me, but it says it's rebellion. So instead, be filled with the fullness of the Holy Spirit. So what I want us to do, now if you're not baptized in the Holy Ghost, you can just pray right at your seat and just ask the Lord to fill you with the Holy Ghost, with the evidence of speaking in other tongues, right? Because being filled with the Holy Ghost helps you to live. He helps you to live. You can't live a godly life. You can't live a blessed life without the Holy Ghost. It's hard, right? And so he wants to help you and lead you and guide you into all truth. So Father, in Jesus' name, we just take this time right now just to refill ourselves with your Holy Spirit. Father, we thank you that in the Bible, oil is a symbol of the Holy Ghost. Father, we already prayed and declared that our oil would never run dry. So right now, we pray in the Holy Ghost to fill us up, to empower us, so that we know what to do, that we know what to say, so that we can walk in power, that we can walk in authority, that we can walk in victory. So we receive an infilling right now in Jesus' name. I want you to just pray in the spirit. Come on, y'all. Come on, pray in the spirit. Don't be shy. Ese. This is a good opportunity to ask the Lord to fill you with the Holy Spirit. You just receive him by faith, not by fear. Ki son dorobo shibrakasi. Ki don dorobo shibrokadasata. Minon dorobo shikira bahade sete. Titon dorobo shibro bahade se. Lord, we rededicate our lives to you. Ki sombrobo worship. We receive the infilling of the Holy Ghost. Ki sobro. Father, we receive so that we can, so that rivers can flow from us. Ki son dorobo shibro kate se debe sipa. Mene me sipa aba sete. Ki son dorobo shibro kede shibrati. Anybody want to receive help with the Holy Ghost? I'll lay hands on you. Anybody want to be filled with the Holy Ghost right now? With the evidence of speaking in other tongues? Come on, y'all. It's fun. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Fill us up, Lord. Fill us up. Fill us with your power. Fill us with your anointing. Ki son dobobo shahabaha. Minon dorobo shubrobo gadasete. Father, we want to experience victory in our lives. God, we want to see what we say. Hallelujah. God, we want to believe you with all our hearts. Ki son dorobo shimanamasate. We want to walk in our authority. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. We want other people to see your glory upon us. And God, when we enter into a room, you enter into a room because you live on the inside of us. Kiton dorobo shibrabagesa. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, gonna give you one more minute. If you're not baptized with the Holy Ghost, you can just put your head down and say, Lord, just fill me now. Fill me now. And then don't speak in English. And then just speak what you hear. Everybody's tongue sounds different. Lord, fill me with your power. Say, Lord Jesus, I believe that I receive my miracle. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Now I want to anoint people with oil who need a miracle. But you need God to intervene. Amen. And if you can, tell me what you're believing God for so that we can agree with you. Okay? Kisondo bushahade. Because we want to be witnesses. Yeah, the rest of you can be seated. Hallelujah. We're going to agree with y'all. Amen? Because you're our family. Right? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Kiton dorobo shika. Minama namasataba. Lord, we thank you ahead of time for intervening. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Lord, I pray in Jesus' name right now, you remind your people of what may be in their lives that's preventing them from operating in faith. See, you can't feel guilty and walk in faith. So what do? You get rid of it. You stop doing what you're doing. Tell God you're sorry, and you leave it. Right? Hallelujah. Somebody say, today's the day for my miracle. Hallelujah. I don't want you to think about how many times you've been in the line. I don't want you to think about how many times you prayed about it. So act like, just clean the slate, start over. Don't be whining and all pitiful because, like, God, this is the 10th time I prayed about this. Well, this time you're gonna believe. You're gonna believe and you're gonna chill. So faith is sweatless. Right? All we have to do is believe God. We think too much. We hold ourselves guilty. We hold ourselves in prison, a mental prison. And so we say we're using faith, but we're not. So today, just call on God's mercy. Say, God, I know I don't deserve it, but you didn't say I had to deserve it. You just told me to have faith. So, since there's so many people, anybody else want to lay hands on people for a miracle? You know, because, look, here. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you for the anointing for miracles today. We thank you for the anointing for miracles. I just want to touch y'all, that's all. Y'all good to go. All right? Praise the Lord. We only got one bottle of oil, though. You have another one? Say, this is my time. This is my season. Hallelujah. Say, God, you are the God of the impossible. What's impossible with me is possible with you. That's why you be God and I'm not. Okay? We're not qualified to be God. We're not qualified to perform miracles. God is. All right, I'm going to anoint all my fingers, or four of them, so I can hit y'all. All right? Say, God, I believe you. I'm ready to receive my miracle. Praise the Lord. Are y'all going to give a testimony when God does your miracle? Don't make me mad. Y'all be holding back on testimonies. I'm like, why do they do that? You know why? You know why you hold back on your testimony? Because you think it's temporary. So you're afraid if you give your testimony that what God did is going to come back on you because you give your testimony. So you hold back instead of telling everybody else and let other people be encouraged about what God did in your life. Say, stop it. Believe God. Give your testimony. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. You got to say it. Guess what? When we give God credit for our miracle, he'll do another one. Right? God's not stupid. He knows when we come up and we're not using no faith. So this isn't a religious thing. All right? Father, I just thank you. Were you going to tell me what it was? All right. So, Father, we thank you in Jesus' name for a miracle where glaucoma is gone. In your left eye? In your left eye. In Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for the doctor's report that'll come back that is gone. What do you need?
It's a new horizon.
In Jesus' name, Father, I thank you for a miracle.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
God, you're a healer. Glaucoma, we call it gone right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for confirming your word with doctor's reports. You want to share yours? Anybody else? She came up for a new job. Say, that's easy. That's super easy. So if you're sitting here today, believe God right now for a new job. You know why? Because God owns the company. So he's going to give his kid a job. Father, we thank you for a new job right now in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you that all of us believing for a job, we're being specific. Not vague. Say, just don't just say, God, give me a job. You be specific. How much you need to make? How far you want to drive? Right? So you have to be specific. Praise the Lord. Father, I thank you for her daughter. That the peace of God will flow through her. And that the spirit of rejection will be gone. In Jesus' name. And that she'll feel your love. Okay. She was in what? Okay, okay. Father, thank you for this daughter. We touch and agree that this daughter will be healed of all the effects of chemicals from being in the military. We thank you for in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You need.
It's a new horizon. It's a new horizon.
Okay.
It's a new horizon.
Okay.
It's a new horizon.
What? Ooh.
It's a new horizon.
Say, no, we're not having that.
It's a new horizon.
No. You will always see. Father, we thank you for healing her retinas right now in the name of Jesus, like only you can. We thank you for it. These eyes are healed in Jesus' name. Say, I believe. I want you all y'all say, I believe I received my healing. I believe I received my miracle. What do you need? Okay. Okay. What, this month? Oh, next month. Okay. Instead of getting married? Oh. Okay. All right. So anybody need a financial miracle, you need to sow something. Pray and ask the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, what should I sow? What money should I sow? So that you can get a harvest because your seed's not big enough to take care of your problem. In Jesus' name, I curse this goiter. In the name of Jesus, thyroid, I call you balanced, normal, healed in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Say, I believe I receive my healing. Hallelujah. And I believe I receive my money that I need in Jesus' name. So sow a seed, okay? What do you need? Okay. Okay. Have not? Okay. Father, I thank you for the miracle of restored relationships in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for fixing it. Thank you, Father, for the miracle of bringing them back together in only the way you can. We thank you for restored relationships. We thank you for healing for her children in the name of Jesus. I bind the spirit of mental illness. I bind the spirit of inheritance. And we just thank you for it in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Y'all good? You can be praying in the Holy Ghost. We're sitting and believing God for something for yourself. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. You want to tell me what you need? Okay. 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 Father, we thank you for a miracle, a mental health miracle. Father, we touch and agree. We all agree with her for a miracle for her son to be restored. To wake up in the morning in his right mind. In Jesus' name, we thank you for the miracle. In Jesus' name, we thank you for your divine intervention. And everything that his mom has prayed will come to pass. What do you need? A perforation? That's a hole? Okay. 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 Come on, agree with her for her son. Okay. Father, we just thank you for a respiratory and an eye healing. In Jesus, and an ear healing. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father, we thank you. And we call everything fixed, repaired, restored, normal, healed, reconstructed, closed. In Jesus' name. Say, I believe I receive. Okay. All right. Okay. We touch and agree with her. Her brother needs a new kidney. So, Father, we thank you for the miracle of a new kidney for her brother. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for this season of miracles. Okay. What happened? Oh, melanoma. What'd you say? What? Oh, malignant tumor in his thyroid. So you're up here for your father. So when y'all come up for somebody else, I need to know about it because that throws me off. Okay? Because I'm laying hands. So you catch me off guard. I need a different type of prayer as far as I'm concerned. So, Father, we touch and agree with your daughter for her father. In Jesus' name, Father, we thank you that malignant tumor, we curse that malignant tumor in her father's throat. In the name of Jesus, malignant tumor, you leave. You leave her father's throat. We call you gone. We send the word of God to her. God, your word says he sent his word and healed them and delivered them from all their destruction. We thank you that her father is healed from destruction. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. And when y'all have relatives, y'all lay hands on your relatives. What you need, Char? Okay. So homeostasis. In Jesus' name, Father, we thank you for a complete overhaul in Charlene's body right now in the name of Jesus, that all her levels would be balanced, her chemical balance, her hormonal imbalance, her organ imbalance would be balanced and healed right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. What do you believe in God for? Your kid? Okay. Okay. In Jesus' name, I lay hands on these kidneys. In Jesus' name. Kidneys, I speak new kidneys. Father, we thank you for the miracle of new kidneys. They said her disease can't be reversed. So, Father, we know you make new kidneys. And you put new kidneys in people. So, Father, we stand here in agreement for a miracle for your daughter for new kidneys. Father, we thank you for confirming your word with signs following and with doctor's report. And they're going to find good kidneys in her body in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. We thank you for that miracle. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Anybody go back to your seat? You believe you receive a miracle? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hello. Hi. Purpose was the second word. Path and patience. Okay. But that's easy. So I know you stick close to people here who help you with your path and your purpose. He'll define your purpose, right? So just don't be anxious. Don't be anxious. Okay. Well, I'd rather God kick me than for me to run out ahead of him. Father, I pray that you would give your son peace about his path and about his purpose. Father, I pray that you would give him peace every day with every move that he makes, and that he would live his life right for you, and that you would open his ears to hear you speak to him. You love him. He's your son. Father, I pray in Jesus' name that you would straighten his path so that there be no doubt. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And God, give him wisdom to raise his family. In Jesus' name. Amen. Okay. Father, we thank you for restoration of her job, restoration and back pay, that you will restore her in every way. Hallelujah. We thank you for it. We thank you for working in her life. We thank you for working in her money. We thank you for working in her heart. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Say, thank you, Jesus. Say, you're going to settle everything. I'm going to have peace. And I'm going to bed tonight. And I'm not going to worry about nothing. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Miracle. Oops. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Father, we thank you for this open window. We thank you for this divine opportunity for us to believe you for miracles, that you're a miracle-working God. And we are in a miracle-working season. And God, you had our Savior born from a virgin. That's a miracle. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Somebody say, God takes care of me. Say, I will lay my head down in peace and rest and leave the hard things to God. Say, I will not worry. I will not fear. I will trust God. I will declare and decree what he has said unto me. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Somebody give the Lord some praise. Father, we thank you for working miracles. We thank you for testimony after testimony after testimony after testimony. Father, we thank you that you're already working. You're working in the spirit realm. You're doing things that we can't see. But you heard our prayers and you heard our requests. So we thank you for it in Jesus' name. Somebody say amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. With every head bowed, every eye closed, I just want to give an invitation. Maybe you're here today and you've never made Jesus the Lord of your life. You've never called him Lord before, and I'd love to pray for you, pray with you. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say a prayer, and then you just repeat after me. And if that's the first time you pray that prayer, then I'm going to ask you to just raise your hand and let me know that you prayed that prayer. Amen. Now, we already rededicated our lives to the Lord, so I don't have to make that call right now. But if you're not born again, then you want to pray this prayer. Say, Lord Jesus, I thank you for dying on the cross for my sins. Say, Lord Jesus, I admit that I'm a sinner and that I need a Savior. And I thank you for dying for me. Say, I believe in my heart and confess with my mouth that you are Lord, Jesus. I also believe that God the Father raised you from the dead after dying on the cross for me. You raised him from the dead, victorious, resurrected to live forever so that I could get born again to call you Lord and live forever with you. Say, Lord Jesus, I ask you now to be my Lord, to be my Savior. Come into my life. Change me. Shape me. Give me direction. Bless me. And I thank you for it now. I call you Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. Anybody pray that prayer for the first time? Anybody, you prayed that prayer for the very first time? You did? Oh, good. Praise the Lord. So we're gonna give you some information. Gary, are you the only one? Say, would you mind coming up? Praise the Lord. We're so happy for you. This is the very first time? Yeah. Oh. Praise God. So what's your name?
Sarah.
Sarah, what's your last name?
Gilliams.
Gilliams. This is Sarah?
Yes.
Gilliams. So, Sarah Gilliams. So, we're so happy for you. Welcome to the family of God. You can call God your Father now. Call Jesus as your Lord. And he's been waiting for you to get saved. And God wants to get busy on directing your life and blessing you and letting you know who you are, why you were, what your purpose is here. And so if you don't have a church home, if you don't come, if you just busy and living faith, we'd be glad to have you come and just sit under the word and grow. And we make a guarantee, no, that's to new members, but anyway, a new convert, if you hear the word of God and you do the word of God, your life won't be the same again. So we thank you. Thank you. So we have some information. You can see that lady back there who's raising her hand. Praise God. Let's give Sarah a hand, everybody. Praise the Lord. Somebody say, this is the time for miracles. Hallelujah. Well, Minister Kim, she's going to lead us in worship with our tithes and offerings.
Pastor, for that mighty word. Everything we need is in the house. Amen. Are you in agreement with that? Amen. Thank you, Pastor, because you are what we need at Living Faith Christian Center, and we're so thankful of your obedience. Amen. Amen. And so your pastor is so in tune with God that everything that happens with a purpose. And so as I'm up here doing tithes and offering, I just want you to understand that Pastor said giving is what we have. We give what we have. We may not have a whole lot. The devil would have us focus on what we have. But whatever we have to give. And you know what? God knows what we have, as she said, and God knows what we need. Amen? So as we prepare for tithes and offering, keep that in mind, that God knows what you have and he knows what you need. But God wants obedient. Amen. If you are joining us online, we ask that you prepare for tithes and offering as well. And we thank you for joining us. And then so as we share a little bit about tithing, we've heard that tithing is a part of our obedience and our worship to God. This is a part of the service as well. So do not just gloss over it. Oh, it's just that time for they need my money. No, they don't need anything. God has everything. Amen. And this is God's house. God wants you blessed. So see this as a time of worship. Whenever you give your tithe and your offering, amen? And remember that God has everything, and everything belongs to God. So God wants to know, can he trust you with more? But he can't trust you with more if you don't give what he's, trust you with what he's already given you, amen? And so tithing in a regular basis is not only to support the financial needs of the church, because that is how the church continues to run, by your tithe and your offering. And we have a good church home. And God has really blessed us in this house, this big, beautiful Ephesus. We are debt-free. The world looks on us and can't believe if they looked at the amount of people in the seats and say, how do you do it? Because we serve a big and mighty God. Amen? And if you want the same blessing in your house, you got to be obedient. Amen? Just do it and watch God do it in your life. Amen? 2 Corinthians 8:19 says, not only that, he has been given, Paul was talking about Titus when he had Titus come to collect the tithe. And he said, not only that, he has been appointed by the church to be our traveling companion as we carry and dispense the generous gifts that glorifies the Lord and shows how eager we are to help. See, even in the day of Paul and Silas and Titus, God had a purpose for your giving. It is about helping and making sure the church is here when people knock on the door, when people call. The church is here. Amen? Proverbs 3:9 says, honor the Lord with your wealth, with the first fruits of your crop. Then your barns will be filled to overflowing, and your vaults will brim over with new wine. We were believing God. Some of us came up believing God for finances and a new job. But don't forget God. Honor him with the first fruits. Amen? Because you want to be obedient. Because Acts 20:35 says, more than that, giving is a blessing. It is more blessed to give than receive. Amen? Amen. And God knows what we have, and he cares, and he knows what we need. Amen. Would you share video ways to give?
Here at Living Faith, we have made giving easy by using electronic options as much as possible. You can text to give by texting LFCCNJ to 77977. You can give once or set up as a recurring gift. Just enter in your details, confirm your gift, and you're done. You can give through our LFCCNJ Church app. This method will look similar to text to give. The iOS version of the app can be downloaded at the App Store, or you can get the Android version on Google Play. You can also give online at lfccnj.com/giving. If these options are not possible, you can obtain a pink envelope and deposit it as you leave. We thank you again for joining us today. God bless you.
Amen. Amen. And we thank God for our technical department, because again, tithes and offerings allowed us to be able to do what we do and have an awesome technical department. Amen. Amen. So I just want to remind you that if you're giving today by envelope, you can put your envelopes in the boxes in the rear when you leave out the sanctuary. All right, let's do with our confession. Stand and confess. Like Pastor said, we got to say something first before we expect something new to happen. Amen. Amen. So let's read together. We decree that because we are tithers, we receive the promise of the scripture that protects those who tithe and give offering. As a household, we are committed to the tithe and given to the Lord's work. Therefore, we claim tithers' rights. That means no devourer, destroyer, waster, plunger, or pillager can rob from us in Jesus' name. They cannot steal our blessing or fruitful harvest. They cannot steal from our homes, businesses, or from any of our loved ones. Amen. The destroyer can't strip away our heritage or harm our children. We stand in a tither's blessing, which promises that the Lord will rebuke the evil one on our behalf. We stand in the tither's blessing that the Lord will open windows of heaven, windows of treasure, and pour out blessings we do not have room enough to receive. We stand confident that the tithe is raising a standard against every demonic plot and attack. We have faith that as Jesus, our Lord and eternal high priest, stands in the heavens receiving our tithe, we are under covenant of his blessing. We prophesy that the promise of the tither rests upon our families in Jesus' name, according to Malachi 3:11, Hebrews 7:8. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. That's so powerful. Jesus is standing in the heaven, receiving our tithe. Thank you, Lord. Reach your hand forward to the altar. God, we thank you, Lord God, that you thought so much of us, God, that you provided everything we need here on earth, God. And we thank you, God, that we can bring the tithe and an offering, Lord God, to you, God, as a sign of worship and obedience, God. God, we ask that you bless our finances. Bless this tithe. Bless this offering, God. And let that 90% multiply, Lord God. And even if it's 80%, Lord God, whatever it is, God, you let it multiply, God, to more, God, so we can have more in store to give, God. Not being concerned about our houses, God, because you said that you would bless us in our households, God. So, God, we stand confidently, God. We come boldly, letting the devil know he failed again. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord God. Now, seed, you go into good ground. You grow, and you bring us back a mighty, mighty, miraculous harvest. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. We serve a mighty God. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. We're going to call up Sister Yvonne Kilson as we prepare to welcome some new members. Amen.
Been introduced, Yvonne Kilson, and I have the pleasure of being the director for member development. And this morning, I have the pleasure to have Pastor acknowledge our newest members who have completed three sessions of the new members orientation class. They've been very patient. They completed in September, actually, but we wanted to get their certificates to them before the end of the year. So we have another class that's in process right now. They're on class number 2, but you know, we continue doing this, but we wanted to get those who completed, acknowledge them, and have Pastor greet them. You call the names. Okay, so the first name would be Johnny Banks.
Johnny
Banks! He is already serving. Has been serving faithfully.
I know, he's already serving.
Yes.
Johnny Banks. Come on, Johnny Banks.
And just so you know, you have to complete classes and interviews in order to serve. You are a member when you join, but in order to serve in the ministry, you need to complete your new member classes and your interview.
You're welcome. Thank you. So you can stand here and face everybody.
And our next
they can stare
member is Jonathan Green.
Jonathan Green. Come on, Jonathan. You're on your own now. No parents covering you. You're your own man.
Our next member is Marshall Kelly, the third.
Marshall Kelly, Marshall Kelly. Where are you, okay. Marshall?
I don't know.
Okay.
He was going to be here, but that's okay. We'll get the certificate to him. Our next member is Joseph LaRosa.
Joseph LaRosa? Come on, let's keep clapping for Joseph. Thanks, Joseph. I'll hug you. And I'll hug you. I didn't hug you. Well, keep proud. Somebody gonna take a picture? They're holding up their certificates. You call
okay,
everybody's name?
The final member is Henrietta Marshall. She would not be able to be here. She had a personal issue, so I will
okay.
be mailing hers.
Okay.
So with that being said, let's welcome them. This was a class that was majority male members. We had one female.
Hoo-ah! Praise God. Well, wait a minute. Let me. Now you're serving already. You're serving already? No, not yet. You serving already? Not yet. Okay. All right. So I'm just going to pray over y'all. You already found the area that you like serving in. So, but Father, we just thank you and we praise you, Father. I thank you for these men of God. I thank you, Father, that you placed them here for such a time as this to serve with us, to serve your vision, to serve your purpose. Father, I thank you for the gifts and talents, abilities that you put on the inside of them since before the foundation of the world. Father, I pray that you would continue to navigate them through the ministry, that they would find and discover the area that's perfect for them, where they're going to be a blessing to the people and help people, encourage people, help them to grow. Father, I just thank you. I pray that the house anointing is on them to serve in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Say amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, gentlemen. God bless you. Thanks for your faithfulness. Praise the Lord. That's a good sight to see. Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm grateful and thankful for everybody that becomes a part of Living Faith and goes through the short little requirements that we have. You know, we just want to make sure you like us, you know, and this is where you want to be. And so you find that out as you go through the three classes. Amen. Praise the Lord. All right. Let's see. We have a New Year's Eve video. Can y'all turn that up louder than the tithes and offering was?
Get ready to bring in the new year with an epic celebration as Living Faith Christian Center and Abundant Life Family Church of Souderton, PA come together to usher in 2024, the year of the open door. Uh-huh. We will kick off the festivities with a one-hour fellowship reception at 9 p.m. Doors open at 8:45 p.m., followed by the main event at 10 p.m. to midnight. Prepare yourself for an evening packed with laughter, games, and all-around good atmosphere. Topped off with impactful messages from Pastor Robert Randolph Woo-hoo! Davis and Pastor Connie McLean as we count down to the new year. We're keeping it semi-formal in the fashion department, so break out your best attire. Just a heads up, though, no childcare will be available this time. It's going to be a night to remember, so make sure you're in on the fun. See you there.
Amen. Praise God. Praise the Lord. I think our last New Year's Eve service was 2019. So, yeah. So this will be exciting. It'll be good to bring in the new year. We were joking yesterday with the deacons how a lot of us were asleep when the new year came in. Past several years, we wake up to text people, oh, Happy New Year. But so we'll be here together to bring in 2024. Amen. And it's going quick. Today's the 10th already, so it's moving fast. So I think you'll enjoy it and have a lot of fun and get an opportunity to dress up. I don't have opportunity to dress up, so that'll be a nice touch, right? All right. Praise the Lord. Well, I want to, let's see, we have a food drive going on December 16th. That's next Saturday. All right, food drive, our monthly food drive, December 16th. Do we have any first-time visitors? Any first-time visitors? Hi. You were the one helping me say what the date was. You went 10. praise God. Do y'all know anybody that comes here? You do? Okay. Are they here today? Okay. All right. So we're so glad you joined us today. And some over here? Where? Raise your hand. Let me see your hand. Can I see? Hi. Welcome to Living Faith. We're so glad you all came to join us today for service. We like visitors. We love visitors. So like I always say, you know where we live now. So you know what we look like inside. One more. Where? Hey. We see you back there. Praise God. Welcome to Living Faith. Come on, y'all. Tell them welcome to Living Faith. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let's give them another hand. Hallelujah. Did we catch everybody? Caught everybody? All right. Anybody want to join Living Faith today? If you've been coming to Living Faith, you want to make Living Faith your church home. You've been coming and you know the Lord is leading you to be a part of this church family. You got to be a part of a church somewhere, a good church. And so if anybody here today, you want to join Living Faith, make Living Faith your church home? Anybody? Anyone? Anyone? Praise the Lord. All right. Okay, everybody. I think I got everything. I also would be open for prayer after I close out in prayer. And I pray you all have a great week, a great Sunday, and that you're blessed in all you do, and that you, Father, we thank you for all the miracles, all the testimonies. Father, we thank you that it's already in the works. And so, Father, whatever we pray for, we know you already know. So our situation doesn't catch you by surprise. So we thank you that you've already provided for us. And God, our problems aren't too hard for you. So we just continue to thank God for his mercy, his graciousness, and for answering our prayers. Father, we just thank you and we praise you, Father. I thank you for everyone under the sound of my voice. Father, as believers, we agree on your word. Your word says that you spoke the blessing to us. Therefore, we are blessed, happy, fortunate, empowered to prosper, and to be envied. Somebody in agreement with that? Say, I'm blessed. And so are you.